Thinking about ordering a Monoprice Select Mini Pro? Maybe you just got it and it's still in the box? I'm going to help you set it up. Don't go away. Hey everybody, it's Paul from Fat Guy Productions coming to you as always from beautiful Las Vegas, Nevada. And yes, I am going to take you through the steps you need to do to properly set up your brand new Monoprice Select Mini Pro. Now, before we go over to the printer, I just want to tell you, I really love this printer. And if you watch one of my review videos, you'll learn more about it. I think it's a wonderful little machine, but that's not to say it doesn't have some faults in it. Let's be perfectly honest. It's being made in China in some slipshod fashion. The directions suck. There are problems with it. But once you get it set up and you work out all those little issues, it's a heck of a little machine. I love its profile. I love how it's very user-friendly. It's easy to use. You know, you can just sit there and knock out a quick print of stuff. Lot of fun. I really do love it. I just hate that Monoprice kind of hung us out to dry and didn't really explain how to properly use or set this thing up. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to go over, I just got this printer, okay? And I'll tell you, it's because my other one broke. But Monoprice took 2 days for me to get it to them, 2 days for them to get me a brand new one in my hand. So I really don't have a complaint coming, all right? Okay, so let's go ahead and go over to the printer and I'm going to show you what to do. All right, so when you get your printer and you get it out of the box, this is not in the instructions. And by the way, the instructions for this printer really suck, okay? It's not in the box, but one of the first things you're going to want to do is you're going to want to just check all the hardware to make sure it's tight. So just get yourself a little screwdriver and just kind of put it in everywhere and check that, make sure that everything is nice and snug. You know, you don't got a monkey wrench, anything like that. But a friend of mine got his and everything was so substantially loose. Okay, after you've checked everything out, go ahead and start removing some of the packing material. You're gonna remove the little screen thingy here. And then you gotta remove this little piece of tape, which is a lot of fun. See, fortunately, they put a little nubbin right here at the top for me, so I was able to get to it and pull it around. And don't be just yanking willy-nilly, okay? Because, again, we're talking about precision machinery, and you don't want to just be yanking on stuff, all right? But you want to get that all the way off of there. Okay, that's the beginning and the end of the packing materials, okay? So now what we can do is we can go ahead and get it into position and go ahead and get it plugged in using the power block that comes with it. So let's do that. All right, now we're gonna take our spool holder and it just kind of slides down over here. No big deal, okay? And we can actually go ahead and put our roll of filament on there. Can't tell I lived in Germany, can you? Yes, that cuckoo clock is from the Black Forest. Okay, so we're kind of ready to start. So let's go ahead and reach in the back and turn on the power. All right, make sure everything boots up. Okay, we got our screen. Everything looks the way it's supposed to look. All right, so far so good. Okay. So we've turned it on, the screens come on, everything looks fine right now. Okay, check our Bowden tube and make sure it's seated properly. Make sure that's seated properly. Everything looks fine. Okay. All right, so I'm happy with what we've got. So what we're gonna go ahead and do now is we're gonna go ahead and go to the preheat screen. And the first thing I wanna do is I wanna turn on the nozzle preheat It comes up automatically at 190. We can just accept that because we're going to have the nozzle hot so that we can feed in the filament. All right. And now what I want to do is I want to kind of move my print head around. Okay. So I'm going to go back. I'm going to go to the move square. Okay. Now here's my control panel. You see, I'm not it at my stops anywhere except on my Y axis. So I'm going to just push home and see that it does what it's supposed to do. Okay, so it's going to figure out where it's at and it's going to go home, which should be right up here. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to move this nozzle so we can load filament. And right now, if you look at the Bowden tube, you see it kind of comes out and then goes up and around and then in and then down. That's a lot of bending for this filament. So I want it to be able to just kind of come out and go straight down. So I'm going to go up on the Z a little bit here, and I'm going to move it all the way over and make that curve in the Bowden tube like this. It'll be a lot easier to feed, okay? So now I can go ahead and get the filament out here. By now, I should be nice and warmed up. I'm going to get a little nipper, and I'm going to cut a point on my filament here. Okay, so I got a nice little point on my filament, and I'm going to just put it in the hole and squeeze the feed unit so that the filament will go in. Now, I'm going to raise it up. Because I want to be able to see underneath the hot end. And I can see, I already have test filament coming out from when they did it. So I'm up to temperature, the nozzle is warm, filament is oozing out. There's a little bit from when they tested it. All right, so now I'm going to go ahead and extrude and see if I can get a little of the orange to start coming out. And there we go, see, it's already coming out orange. Okay, so my filament is threaded through, I'm at temperature, it's feeding nicely, all of that is fine. Okay, so now I can go ahead and home it again. Okay, so I'm homed, the nozzle is warmed up, everything is good. I'm going to raise the print head up a little bit just to keep it out of the way. I'm going to move it over just a hair and then move the bed forward all the way. Okay. Now this is a magnetic bed, and we're gonna go ahead and pop this off. So I just lift on one corner, then the other corner, and then I just kind of pop it off here. I don't wanna be crashing it into the print head. Okay, so I'm gonna take a look at this. Now see, it already came with a little ding in it. All right, I may change this out pretty quick. It already has a little gotcha mark in it. But what I want to do here is I want to go ahead and clean that. So, I'm going to get me a paper towel. All right. A little paper towel and some isopropyl alcohol. And the reason I'm going to clean it right now, even though I haven't used it yet, is because who knows what they've done to it. And a dirty bed, an unlevel bed, and a bed that is too far away from the nozzle are 100% of the reasons why you can't get stuff to stick. So I've cleaned it off. I'm going to let that dry for a second. And while I do that, I can shake up my Aquanet Extra Super Hold Hairspray. Do you need this? Do you need blue painter's tape? Do you need glue sticks? You should not need any of this. But I figure putting the hairspray on is easy enough to do, so why not? So let's put a little coat on here. All right, just about like that. And then I can go ahead and put this back on the bed. Okay, like so. And now I'm going to go back and I'm going to turn on the bed heat. Go to preheat, bed, 50, and say yes. I'm going to let that warm up and dry. And I'm going to put three coats of the hairspray on it. And then after every five prints, I clean it with alcohol and I put another coat of hairspray on there. So we'll let that dry for a second. Okay, so right about now, we're pretty set up and ready to print. All I need to do is put in the little card they sent me, all right? But there's one last hugely important thing to do, and that is to set the distance between your bed and your nozzle. Now, that's a fairly complex issue, and I'm going to put out an entire second video on doing that with this video. So you'll see two videos come up. They'll be in a playlist. So you'll need to go through both of them, but this will be the most important part of the entire setup, and that's why I don't want to try and cram it all into one thing. So, okay, that is everything you need to do to set up your printer, except setting the distance between your nozzle and your bed. Okay? Failing in doing that and doing it correctly, you're going to have all sorts of problems. But it was too big an issue to tackle here. I just briefly touched on it, okay? I'm releasing a second video right with this video. Back to back, I'll put them into a playlist as well that will go over all the steps you need to do to set your bed distance, okay? You have to watch that. You have to do it. It will account for 85% of any failures you're going to have. All right, I'm going to go ahead and get out of here. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up, click subscribe, ask any questions, make any comments that you might have. I really do love to chat with you guys. This is Paul from Fat Guy Productions. I'm getting out of here. Until next time, have an amazing, super stupendous day, and be good.